Hi, everybody. I'm Sam Darty.
And I'm Kim White.
We're from Paid Memberships Pro. And today we're going to be discussing and showing you how you can use our import members from CSV add-on in the most basic way. Kim, what can our support team do to help people with this technical add-on?
So we can help you if you've prepared your CSV file and still find you're having issues with it. Our team can review it for you. Quite often, if you have a large audience, you could give us a few rows and we can be able to maybe point out and see things where there's problems in formatting or titles. So we'll review that information. If you're getting errors during the import, maybe we could troubleshoot those with you. What we can't do is build your import file for you. That's something your team needs to do, but we're willing to review it with you so you can have a greater success.
We will also not import on your site for you, specifically doing the whole import aspect of it. So, but we do have support to help you. This is a technical add-on. It is very, very easy to make mistakes. I've done it before. It's likely I'll probably do it here. Kim has done it. So take your time. Ask questions. Premium support is extremely helpful for this. But we're also going to do our best in this video to explain what's needed, what can cause some trip ups, and how you can get your members into your WordPress and Paid Memberships Pro space. So with that, we're going to dive right in. So I do have our add-ons page pulled up for you for the import member from CSV add-on. Like I said, this is a plus add-on. You will either need a license key for plus from Paid Memberships Pro, a validated in your WordPress memberships dashboard, or you will need to get this add-on from GitHub. So those are two avenues that you can get this add-on from. On my demo site, I do have a license key installed and activated or validated on my site. And so I'm going to search for the add-ons under memberships. And then I'm going to activate it. Perfect. Now that it's installed and activated, we go to users. We can go import members. And from here, we're going to download the example CSV file. We can also download it from our documentation page. It's the exact same file, just two different places where you can get the file. I'm going to download it from here, and then I will open a Google spreadsheet to be able to edit this file. I'll import it into my spreadsheet for then. Okay, so now we have our spreadsheet, and let me zoom in just a little bit for you so we can see this better. There we go. In our documentation, we will see, if I can find it, what is required and what is optional for the column headings that we're going to have. The column headings have to be super, super specific. And if they are not exactly how they're shown in this documentation on your spreadsheet before you convert it to a CSV, it will not work. The headings that are absolutely needed are going to be user ID, user login, or user email. And for the membership side, if you should be using this to assign a membership level. So you would also want to make sure you assign a membership ID so they are attached to a level. Your levels should already be created in your memberships section of your WordPress site. If you do not have your levels set up already, go back and set up your levels, because that is how you grab those level ID numbers and actually attach it to your member and your users. So with that, we're going to review what's on here. So we have our user login for four different members. We have their email. User pass is user password. However, we do recommend do not set the user password. Kim, if you want to go over why we don't want to do that.
Well, it can be a security issue, and I don't think it really works one-on-one with this. It involves a little more developmental. So if you're a developer and understand salts and how the passwords go in, maybe. But for security reasons, it's always good to allow your users to create their own password. And they can do that with WordPress without a problem. So.
They can. And WordPress also allows you to bulk send password reset links. So after you get all of your users in with their membership level, you can bulk send that email for them to each individually get their reset link for them to go in and do that on their own, which is the way more secure way. And
yes,
it makes sense for everybody else. That way they don't have to remember that it's like my first initial and last name plus my birthday, whatever, to log in.
They can set up their own password. No.
So then user login, user email. Those are our required ones. And I did this before. I like to just bold. That way I know I have what is required for looking at it. That bolding it is not going to affect your import. You can add information like first name, last name, their display name. The role you typically want to assign, if you're going to assign a role here, it's not required that you do. This is optional. If you do, it's typically recommended that you stick to subscriber. It can be that because of WordPress capabilities, if you assign a higher level role, that they will have more access to potentially things like your WordPress admin. Not something you want to give your members.
And if you don't populate that column, they will get the subscriber by default.
Membership ID, here is another column that is going to be required. This is where we're going to put in that ID number, and I'm going to show you where we get that. Now, the rest of this is a lot of other information that is all optional. I would recommend not trusting what's on here and actually going through either removing the entire column itself or updating it for what you would like it to do for information that you want to put in there. But what is required, membership ID, user email, user login. Membership ID. Let's go make sure that if I was to actually import this, they would be getting levels because these numbers could be very different on your site. So if we go back to our demo site, we go memberships settings. Here we have our membership levels. And we even have some 5 and 6 in a different level group. For this, we can use 1, 2, 3. That's fine. If you wanted to change this to where we'll say Jerry Doe is going to get level 5, you can do that. Kim, now that we have level groups and you can have more than one membership per user, can I add more than one level ID?
That would involve doing a second import of the user. And there are directions on the page on how that would be done.
Perfect. Okay. So you would not want to do like 3, 5. That will not
right.
give them
it
both levels.
It doesn't work that way.
One level, one import. Perfect. Okay. So now I think this is ready to go. And I will file download as a CSV. That is downloaded. So now we're going to go back to our users import member screen. We're going to choose our file. And then here we have a few different options about what we want to do when it comes to how this import behaves. We can send a email to new users and notify them of their username and link to reset password. So you have that option to do that. We can also update existing members. So if they have information already, if we already have user information for a person in this spreadsheet, we can update, we can click this and update the existing user to then match everything. We can process the import in batches using Ajax. This is recommended if you do have a larger file. Kim, what would be a larger file?
I would say anything over, I don't know, I've heard different. It depends on your server and processor. You could do them in hundreds. I think that would be a safer thing. But it, once you get 500 or more, and we have had people with that, it would be good to use that.
We also do recommend testing your file with about like 5 to 10 members before you do something like hundreds,
yes.
500. If you have 1,000, you know, I'll test in a smaller number first. And then we also could say that we want to skip existing members. So if we had existing members on our spreadsheet and we did not want to change information, then that is what we would put. I'm going to leave this as such because right now I don't think my site has any members. So I want them all to come in. I want everything to update. And for my instance, as a demo, I do not need to notify John. I'm going to import. And now I want to check our members list in our membership dashboard to see if this all came through. So we'll do memberships, members, and we do have Jane, Julie, and Jerry, but we had 4 and that's only 3. So who are we missing? And why are we missing this person? If I go back to my spreadsheet.
Good old John.
It is good old John Doe.
Yes.
Apparently we're picking on John Doe today a lot. That's okay. Okay, so why did John Doe not come over? Why does he not have a membership? Does he even have a user in our site? So let's check the users. And apparently I do have members in this site. But let's search for John. Did John Doe even... John Doe is a user. Let's see if we edit member. Memberships. He did not get a membership level, but he has membership history. So now we can go back to our import and we can find out that I bet you he expired. And we didn't know because we didn't check all of those extra optional fields at the end of the spreadsheet. So if I go back to John Dale, let's see. Initial payment was 50. Ending amount was 50. We have our cycle. So he should have been active. His start date was 2020. But here we go. His membership ended January 2nd of 2025. Well, it's January 17th. So he's expired. He lost his membership. So, but if we either remove this or we change it, then he would have his membership level.
In most cases, when you're importing people, you probably want an expiration date. Especially, we're not talking if subscriptions, because an expiration date is how they'll have the membership level and they'll be reminded when to renew or when to pay. So in most cases, you are going to want to have a valid expiration.
That is true. That is true.
End date.
So we'll give him the end date of March 8th, 2025. And then we're going to export this again. And I'm going to do that just so I can show you how we can fix when issues like this occur. Okay, so we have that exported. We're going to go back to our users, import members. We're going to choose our file, and I hope it's the right file. This is a situation where, one, we do have the user in our site, and two, we want to update that existing user so they end membership. So we will click Update Existing Users and click Import. Now, if we go back to Membership Members, John Doe should have a level. And now we have Jane, Julie, John, and Jerry.
Perfect.
As someone who should have known to go check the end of the spreadsheet and did not, you can see that it's very easy to make mistakes on this. The other option, if it is just that one member that did have a issue with their membership level, I could have gone where I was with John Doe and just updated their membership. But it's possible that you have a list of 50 members and they're all users, but they didn't get a level because the end date was set. And it would be very tedious to go back and change all 50 members. So this does allow you to do that.
You could also, when you're looking at your members list, because people have written us and I imported everybody, but they're not there. If you look under old users, you can usually end up seeing them there. And then you can know, okay, the imported worked, but they didn't get something
right.
went wrong.
I don't
and
have
you can
any
sort
old
that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's
you can,
a, nice,
you can
that's a
that.
Resource.
Say you already have the information of a company name for your users that you want to import into your Paid Memberships Pro to have as member data. How do you even go about doing that? You can import that too. If we go to settings in our memberships, and then we go to user fields, I already have these user fields created, but I will link the documentation in the description on how you can create these user fields. In the, for the field, is how you would put it in the column heading to get that information into your members' user meta. So we will copy this name and we'll go back to our spreadsheet and we will go ahead and just create a new column. I will insert one column to the right. It does the order of the columns matter, Kim?
No, it doesn't. However, most of the time, these fields end up being at the end because they're part of an export or something, but it really doesn't matter.
That makes sense. In my case, I don't have anybody. I have Doe's. We'll add the company name, Paid Memberships Pro, to John. We're really picking on John. And then let's export this again. We'll download it as a CSV. We will go back to users, import members. I will choose my file. In this case, I'm going to select the update existing users. Ideally, you would want to have all of this information in your first import and you don't have to come back like I did to add this additional information. But I'm going to update the existing user. I will import this. And then I will go to membership members. And I will edit member, not Jane Doe.
Yep.
Membership members. I will edit member John Doe. And I have my user field group, company information. Company name has been populated to be Paid Memberships Pro from my CSV. So you can do that with any custom information you have on your users. If you have their birthday, pet's name, our must love dog demo site, we always say like, what's your dog's name and your dog breed? Any of that personal information on your members you can bring over. Okay, so Kim, I did this on my demo site, but what if I had a live site?
You would want to back up your database. Every once in a while, people get incorrect results. If you're doing more extensive information, it could not work the way and you can't really fix it easily. So the only way would be to roll back. So make sure you have a backup of your database and you're prepared. You know how to restore it.
Perfect. And that's you important. Can get more in depth with this. The CSV does allow you to import subscription information, and you can really go in depth of membership history of that initial payment and the recurring payment and so many good details that you could find in your Paid Memberships Pro about your members. But this is the basic what is truly required for importing your members. If you want to go deeper, we really do recommend premium support. Like Kim said before, we can help you look at your file, we'll review it, we will suggest changes to make it successful. We will not create the file for you and we will not import the file for you. But that is our import members from CSV add-on. Please like and subscribe to the video and our channel, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, Sam.